This is the MCQ, and if you have marked the answer as option number E, you are right. Okay, so let us see what is the TZANCK SMEAR. It is basically a cytodiagnostic test in which we are going to select vesiculobullous lesions. We will deroute the vesicle with the help of the scalpel, and with the blunt end of the scalpel, we will scrape the base of these, erosions, and then we will, fix this over a glass slide, and we are going to apply GM sustain, and then after doing all this, we can do observe it this under the microscope. Then we can see various presentation, that is various types of cells can be noted in different diseases. Like for example, you can see this is the TZANCK cytology taken from IJDVL article. So in the immunobullous and the infective, we are concerned about this TZANCK cytology. In Pemphigus vulgaris, you can notice that we are able to see acantholytic cells, which are basically keratinocytes, which have lost their intercellular connections because of the damaged desmosomes. And in the case of toxic epidermal necrolysis, which is a severe cutaneous adverse drug reaction to various drugs, we can see necrosed basal cells, that is necrosed keratinocytes, can be noticed. And in the case of Staphylococcal scalded skin syndrome, which is basically toxin mediated condition, which is just an extinction of the bullous impetigo due to the epidermolytic toxin A and B being hematogenously spread, we can notice the acantholytic cells being present in the TZANCK SMEAR. And of course, we should not forget in the infective condition, there are viral infections which can be diagnosed, but apart from that, even Leishmaniasis can be diagnosed, where we can notice Leishman Donovan body is being seen in the TZANCK SMEAR. And in the viral infections, herpes simplex, varicella zoster virus, that is chickenpox, and also herpes zoster and molluscum contagiosum virus. So in all of them, TZANCK SMEAR can be used, where we can notice the multinucleated germ cells and acantholytic cells in the herpes infections and molluscum contagiosum. We can notice intracytoplasmic eosinophilic inclusion bodies, that is Henderson bodies, can be noted. So these are all the uses of the TZANCK SMEAR. And this is a tomorrow's MCQ. If you know the answer for this, please do leave it in